Hello, Vital Sign. This video covers the combinatorics behind Fadi-Bruno's formula and set partition, which I covered in an earlier video. In this video, we're going to talk about the ways to partition a set according to a specific integer partition. This concept is related to Stirling partition numbers, which count the number of ways to partition a set of n distinct elements into k nonempty subsets. However, what we're interested in this video is the number of ways to partition a set of n distinct elements into k nonempty subsets according to a specific integer partition. What's the difference then between partitioning a set into nonempty subsets and partitioning a set into nonempty subsets according to a specific integer partition? Well, first let's review the number of ways to partition a set of n distinct elements into k nonempty subsets. How many ways can we partition these four elements into two nonempty subsets? We could place A, B, and C together in one subset and D on its own in another, A, B, D in one subset and C on its own, B, C, D together and A on its own, or A, C, D together and B on its own. Hold on though. We could also place A, B together in one subset and C, D in the second subset, or we could place A, C in one subset and B, D in another subset, or we could place A, D in one subset and B, C in the other subset. Since we do not allow for empty subsets, these are all seven ways of partitioning a set of four elements into two non-empty subsets. An important point is that AD in the first subset and BC in the second subset is considered the same partition as BC in the first subset and AD in the second subset. In other words, the order of the subsets don't matter. Also, the order of the elements in the subsets does not matter either. All that matters is who is grouped with who. And this matters because the elements are distinct. Now, when we found there were seven ways to partition four distinct elements into two non-empty subsets, we found the value of the Stirling partition number S42, where 4 is the size of our set, and 2 is the number of non-empty subsets to partition that set into. However, notice that there were two unique ways we grouped the elements. 3 elements together and 1 on its own, and 2 together and 2 together. This is because there are two different ways we can write 4 as a sum of positive integers less than or equal to itself, such that our sum contains exactly 2 summons. Those ways are 3 plus 1 and 2 plus 2. So while S42 equals 7 gives us the big picture about partitioning a set of n into k, it leaves out important details. Those details are that there are different configurations of subsets, each corresponding to a specific integer partition of n. In our example, there were two different configurations of subsets, 3 plus 1 and 2 plus 2, and there were 4 ways of partitioning our elements according to the integer partition 3 plus 1 equals 4, and 3 ways of partitioning our elements according to the integer partition 2 plus 2 equals 4. That is the difference between asking the number of ways to partition a set of n distinct elements into k non-empty subsets and asking the number of ways to partition that set according to a specific integer partition. So is there any formula for counting the number of ways of partitioning a set of n distinct elements into k non-empty subsets according to a specific integer partition? Yes, it is the very same formula used to compute the coefficients of each term in Fadi-Bruno's formula. This formula here tells us the ways to partition a set of n distinct elements into k non-empty subsets according to a specific integer partition, where that specific partition is defined like this, where M1 is the number of times 1 appears in that integer partition, M2 is the number of times 2 appears in that integer partition, and so on. If we're talking about the partition 2 plus 2 of 4, then M2 is 2, and M1, M3, and M4 are 0. Notice that since each M tells us how many times a summand of a given value appears, the sum of all the M's is the total number of subsets, or summons, in our integer partition. This is K. You may be wondering, how was this formula derived? Well, let's find out by working through some examples. First, what are the ways to partition a set of three distinct elements according to the specific integer partition 2 plus 1? It is 3 choose 2, as when we choose the 2, we are automatically choosing the remaining 1, as the order of subsets doesn't matter. However, what if we had 8 elements that we wanted to partition according to 1 plus 3 plus 4? Well, we could start by finding the number of ways to pick the subset of 4. That would be 8 choose 4. Then, for each of those ways, there are 4 choose 3 ways to arrange the remaining 4 elements into the subset of 3. And then there is 1 choose 1 ways to arrange the remaining 1 element into the subset of 1. So that would be 8 choose 4 times 4 choose 3 times 1 choose 1. Notice that the top number in each factor is the top number in the previous factor minus the bottom number in the previous factor. Let's find this product now. Notice how all of the numerators, except for the 8 factorial, cancel out, while the denominator is the product of the sizes of each subset. We're getting closer to our formula now, but we're not there yet. What if we have repeating numbers, like in a partition of 7, according to 2 plus 2 plus 3? In this partition, 2 occurs twice. We could still begin the same way. 7 choose 3 times 4 choose 2 times 2 choose 2. Our denominator has a 2 factorial squared because there are 2 subsets of size 2. Generally, the powers of each factorial of a number j are the number of times denoted by mj a subset of size j occurs in that specific partition of n. In this case, j would be 2, and mj is 2, for in the partition 2 plus 2 plus 3, 2 occurs twice. Now, there is a big problem with this method of counting. We would be overcounting because the order of the subsets does not matter. When we get to the last 4 elements and partitioning them according to 2 plus 2 equals 4, when we multiply by 4 choose 2, we are counting the 6 choices of AB, AC, AD, CD, BD, and BC in one subset as distinct choices, when in reality only half of them count. Since choosing AB in the first subset automatically chooses CD for the other subset. Choosing AC automatically chooses BD for the other subset, and so on, and the orders of the sets don't matter. To prevent this overcounting, we could divide by the permutations of the subsets with the same size. In this case, there are 2 subsets with the same size, which gives us 2 factorial permutations. Now, if we had a partition that started something like this, we would divide by 3 factorial, as the 2's appear 3 times in the partition, creating 3 factorial permutations and redundancies. In other words, we have to leave those permutations of the subsets of the same size out of our count by dividing by those permutations. With this, we can arrive at our final formula for counting the ways of partitioning a set of n distinct elements into k nonempty subsets according to a specific integer partition, where that specific integer partition is defined by the numbers m1 through mn that tell us how many times 1, 2, 3, etc. appear in the partition of n, and where m1 through mn sum to the total number of subsets that we are partitioning into, which is k. The intuition behind this formula is that these factors are there to prevent overcounting that results from the permutations of subsets of the same size, and these factors are in the denominator to prevent the overcounting from the permutations of individual elements within each subset. Here's one final example to show you the formula in action, showing how our method of counting the ways to partition 8 according to 1 plus 3 plus 4 match up nicely to our formula. And that's it. That's how we count the number of ways to partition a set of n distinct elements into k nonempty subsets according to a specific integer partition, defined by the sequence of numbers m1 through mn, where m1 tells us the number of times 1 appears in that specific partition, m2 tells us the number of times 2 appears in that specific partition, and so on, and where m1 through mn sum to k. I hope this helped you understand the combinatorial meaning of the coefficients in Fa di Bruno's formula. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Have a great day.